as the town manager for Danvers, and they must like him there. Must be doing something right. Please welcome.
Hi, Flash. Good morning. I'd like to start by talking a little bit about Will Scanlon. He mentioned he's been mayor for 18 years. Well, for all 18 of those years, it's been my privilege to share this podium with Will Scanlon. He's a leader. He's an outstanding visionary, a very good friend, personally, and to all of us in this room. Bill, I want to assure you, first, thank you for your service and your leadership. And I want to assure you that you have made a difference on this election. I'd like to thank the Chamber for the opportunity to speak with you today. I thought I would limit my remarks to what's happening on the education front in Danvers. First, I'll focus on a significant, long anticipated, very important success that we all share. After more than 15 years, last year we finally broke ground for the Essex Technical High School, which is being built here in Danvers, a property which is now the Essex Aggie High School. This long awaited $133 million project could not have been accomplished without the partnership of the 17 member communities, the Mass School Building Authority, who committed $77.5 million, our governor, and our legislature, led by former Senator Fred Berry, who committed another $21.1 million. This is an extraordinary partnership that will reap benefits for the North Shore and beyond for decades to come. Foresight and the generosity of the mayors, city councils, boards of selectmen, area residents, and this North Shore Chamber deserve to be commended. In less than 1 year, students will enter the new state-of-the-art facility, situated on a 42-acre complex of farm, pasture, and carrot land, with 22 agricultural, vocational, and technical programs offered in four distinct academies. These are animal and plant sciences, construction technology, life and natural sciences, and technology and services. The new school is designed for 1,440 students who occupy 337,000 square feet of space, which includes a 70,000 square foot farmstead. As of today, the work is 60% complete, and if you haven't driven by it, I invite you to do so. It's an impressive sight. The second item I'd like to talk about is also education related. There's been a buzz around Danvers for this past summer, and it stems from a long-awaited opening of the new Danvers High School. After more than 2.5 years of construction, last week, our students and teachers arrived at a new $71 million state-of-the-art secondary school. The project consisted 142,000 square feet of space, of which 150,000 was renovation, or as we like to describe it, recycling of our buildings, and 92,000 square feet of new construction. The project was initially estimated to cost $8 million, but a favorable bidding climate shaved that number by $9 million. The final total is expected to be slightly below our $71 million approved budget. On time and below budget, words that the residents of Danvers appreciate. We'll have a formal dedication on October 26th at 10 a.m., followed by student guided tours, and you are all invited. These two schools represent an investment of public resources of more than $200 million. Coming on the heels of the recent opening of the $30 million health services building at North Shore Community College in Danvers, have a current investment in public education within the town of Danvers approaching $250 million. This bodes well, not just for Danvers, but for the entire North Shore region. The British philanthropist George Gibbon said it best when he described education as, quote, a debt due from present to future generations, end quote. By all accounts, we're living up to that high standard, and it promises a bright future for our region. My pleasure to speak to you this morning. Thank you for your time.